Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Happy New Year to everybody. What I will be presenting tonight, it was a challenge from other bloggers, you know. I want to prove something from the previous vlog of that blogger. That blogger says we are given 1 = 2. Okay? He should ask in his blog that 1 = 2, but there was an error in that blog. For now, I want to show you where the error is. Okay, let's try to start. We let x equal to y. Okay? I want to prove that 1, I want to prove that 1 is not equal to 2. It should not be equal. Because from the blog of that blogger, he said that 1 is equal to 2. I want to show you the error, okay? We start. Well, we let x equal to y for the meantime. Okay? We add y to both sides. So, x plus y should be equal to y plus y. Okay? So, if we try to simplify this one, x plus y is equal to y plus y is 2y now. This will now be 2y. Okay? There's no violation yet on that portion. We are only adding something on both sides, so there's no violation yet. There's no violation in algebra, okay? The next procedure is we multiply both sides by y again, by y. So x plus y equal to 2y times y, meaning the whole equation will be multiplied by y. Try to expand. Okay? X times y is xy. Y times y is y squared. Equal to 2y times y is 2y squared. Okay, that's still fine. Okay? If you try to multiply both sides by same quantity, there's no violation. Okay? Let's try to subtract minus 2xy to both sides. Minus 2xy. So xy plus y square minus 2xy. Okay, we subtract both sides by minus 2xy equal to 2y square minus 2xy. Let's try to simplify. Xy minus 2xy is minus xy. Okay, this is plus y squared. So what remains on the left will be y squared minus xy equal to 2y squared minus 2xy. The common factor is 2, so we factor out 2 here times the quantity y squared minus xy. From the previous blogger, he tried to cancel out this one here. Okay? If we try to cancel out y squared minus xy and y squared minus xy, what will come out will be 1 is equal to 2. But there is an error on this one. You know why? Okay, I will present the proof that this is wrong. The proper way to do this is you cannot just cancel out like that, because in algebra, to cancel out, you should cancel terms on the numerator and denominator, but not on the left side and the right side. There's no essence on that one. The proper way to cancel out is it should be numerator over denominator, and to do that, We should do y squared minus xy all over y squared minus xy equal to y squared minus xy all over y squared minus xy. Actually, we can now make the cancellation, okay? So what will come out is 1 is equal to 2. But there is an error on this one. You are violating the laws of zero. Because a 0 over 0 is indeterminate. A 0 over 0 is indeterminate. You try to use your calculator, you place 0 over 0, it will not come out. It should be an error. Because I want to prove that one. Since at start x is equal to y, try substituting x equal to y to this, to this equation here. Try to substitute. Okay, what will come out is y squared minus xy, but x is equal to y, so this should be y squared. Even on the bottom portion, it's the same, y squared minus y squared equal to 2. Right side, it's still the same, y squared minus y squared over y squared minus y squared. But you cannot cancel out this one. You know why? Because y squared minus y squared is 0, y squared minus y squared is 0, okay, equal to 2, y squared minus y squared is 0, and again, y squared minus y squared is 0. What will come out is 0 over 0, equal to, is it equal to 2 times 0 over 0? Because 0 over 0 is actually indeterminate. So you cannot say that this should be 1 and this should be 1 and you say 1 is equal to 2. You are very wrong. So actually 1 is not actually equal to 2. And that's the proof. Because if you say 1 is equal to 2, but you are violating the laws of 0 over 0, and that is indeterminate. Anything divided by itself except 0 is 1, okay? No. Any number divided by itself is 1 except 0. Because in this instance, what will come out on the left is 0 over 0, and on the right, it is also 0 over 0. And that is not equal to 1. So 1 is obviously not equal to 2. That's the proof that 1 is not actually equal to 2. Because in his solution, he cancels out this 1, and this will become 1, and this will become 1, so he says 1 is equal to 2. That's wrong. Okay? That's for clarity. Okay, I think that's just more than good enough for tonight. I have proven that 1 is not really equal to 2. And the proper way to prove that one is that we are violating the laws of 0 over 0 if we say that 1 is equal to 2. 1 should not be equal to 2. Thank you.